decisions under time constraints in a complex environment and often under ambiguous circumstances. Mistakes are guaranteed. Accordingly, referees' decisions may be crucial to a team's potential league win or avoidance of relegation. Since the referee's fundamental role is to serve as an impartial leader who does not favour one team over another, their mistakes should be equally likely to favour either team. Nevertheless, players, managers, and fans all aim to influence referees so they will make mistakes in their team's favour, and many fans and managers of clubs in the bottom half of the table or with lower reputations feel referees are influenced by the size of a club when making a decision. So let's examine, is this the case? Do referees, especially Premier League ones, favour the big clubs, or does it just feel that way to clubs of smaller sizes and there's not actually any bias involved? So there's actually been a lot of studies on referees and their behaviour, which is going to help us a lot with this. According to a cross-sectional study of Norwegian top-class football referees, most report that their decision-making is unaffected by noise, disturbance, previous mistakes, or other behaviours. Other studies indicate that referees' mistakes are unequally distributed across teams. For instance, it was found that referees are more likely to award a penalty to their home team, suggesting that they may be subconsciously influenced by the home crowd noise. This is consistent with other findings, demonstrating that referees are biased towards their home team when awarding penalties, distributing extra time, and handing out cards. The magnitude of referee bias also appears to be more prominent with increased crowd capacity, and referees with higher anxiety levels are more prone to the influence of social forces, such as crowd noise, compared with less anxious referees. Therefore, despite the intention and perception of impartiality, the cumulative evidence suggests that referees' decisions are influenced by other factors. So it's clear referees, whether they are doing it consciously or not, can be influenced in their decision making. So now we know that referees can be influenced. Can referees be influenced though by the size of a club? Now focus on potential referee bias in favour of successful teams or athletes has increased. For instance, in a study done in figure skating, it was found that figure skaters who were known to the judges received higher marks compared to unknown athletes, suggesting a potential reputation bias. However, transferability of these findings to other sports is questionable. In a 2018 study of the NBA, no evidence was found of a basketball referee bias towards the home team, star players, or teams with better reputations, suggesting that referee bias may be context dependent. In the context of football, referee bias has been reported to favour higher level teams. They tend to add more time for higher level teams when they are behind and less time when they are ahead. Using a statistical approach to analyse whether teams experience winning streaks were favoured by referees, a 2018 study found evidence that one of four teams investigated received preferential treatment from the match referees. However, while a statistical approach is valuable, it is impossible to evaluate the correctness of referees' decisions without observing those decisions. Now, that leads us into a very, very interesting study into this debate done in Norway. Four male Norwegian Premier League, we'll call it the NBL, referees were studied in order to investigate referees' penalty decisions. these situations were examined for all matches played by Rosenberg or Mould against other NPL teams during an entire season. So here were the results. They were very fascinating. The overall agreement between the people investigating, that can be referred to as the EB, and the match referee was 69.4%. Among the 55 situations not including a successful team, the EB identified 30 penalties, while the match referees only awarded 22 penalties. Of the 43 potential penalty situations involving the successful team, the match referee awarded 11 penalties to the successful teams and just one to their opponent. The EB's assessment of the same situation was that the successful teams should have been awarded 10 penalties, one less than they were, and that their opponent should have been awarded 8 penalties, 7 more than they were awarded. Over the course of an entire season, the two successful NPL teams were awarded 110% of their penalties identified by the EB, while their opponents were awarded just 12.5%. Further analysis revealed that the two successful teams were more likely to benefit from a discrepancy between the EB and match referee, as they received a penalty in 25% of the situations the EB would have dismissed, compared with 0% their opponents received. Furthermore, their opponents were more likely to be denied a penalty that the EB would have awarded, as the match referee dismissed 87.5% of the penalties identified by the EB for successful teams' opponents, compared with just 22% for the successful team. So, the results support the idea that there is a referee bias in favour of successful teams, with the evidence indicating that successful teams are more likely to receive an incorrect penalty than their opponents, and that successful teams are less likely to be denied a penalty that they should have been awarded. Now, since this was before VAR, referees did not always view situations from the best angle, and some situations may have occurred outside the referee's field of view. Mistakes certainly occur. Such results are likely explained by the EB having a greater opportunity to identify attacks when viewing the situations on video. Now, while it is unreasonable to assume that every referee mistake is biased, the rate of mistakes made by an unbiased referee should be equally distributed among teams. However, the data shows that successful teams were awarded 110% of the penalties identified by the EB, while their opponents were only awarded 12.5%. So if we are going off the data, then yes, big teams are favoured by the refs. However, the study did have limitations, as although the situations from an entire season were included, the number of potential penalty situations was actually quite low. And also, you know, we don't want to generalise, this is just one study. But there was also another study conducted using existing data by footy stats in 2021. They found that the European football clubs have experienced the most bias in their favour in the last 10 years in Europe's top 5 leagues were the following: FC Barcelona, Napoli, Nimes, Borussia Dortmund and AFC Bournemouth. And they also found the European clubs that experienced the most bias against them in the last 10 years were Leganes, Gievo, Dijon, Hanover and Fulham. They based their study on the number of cards received by the clubs, and it's interesting that Barcelona, Napoli, Dortmund and Bournemouth expressed the most positive bias in their respective leagues, and they're all big clubs in their league besides Bournemouth. On the other hand, in terms of the most bias against them, Arnhem, Chievo, Dijon, Hanover and Fulham are all teams who have been relegated multiple times in the last 10 years, suggesting smaller clubs do get unfair treatment when it comes to costs. If we have a look just at the Premier League stats, the data is even more worrying. Of the top 10 teams who receive buys in their favour in the Premier League over the last 10 years, all of the Big Six clubs are in the top 10, with only Bournemouth, Wolves, Palace making it in the top 10. And the top 4 teams who receive the most buys against them were Fulham, Burnley, Watford and West Brom, all teams who have been yo-yoing from a Premier League and not really considered big clubs. So what conclusions can be made? Successful teams' influence can impact their match referees' important decisions. Given that the results of these decisions may advantage certain teams throughout the season, this issue concerns the fairness of the game overall. Referees' abilities to cope with various sources of pressure should be considered when evaluating their expertise. Perhaps more importantly, referees' federations should be aware of these findings and aim to develop relevant training methods so referees can better resist the influences of clubs. Overall, the data does suggest that big teams are favoured when it comes to penalties for and against them, and big teams are also favoured when it comes to the amount of cards they receive and are given to the opposition. I have to say, observing the games as well, it does feel like there is a bias when it comes to big teams versus smaller clubs. Whether this bias is intentional or not, I'm not sure. I doubt it. But I think subconsciously the referees naturally favour the bigger side in the game, especially